I'm going to demonstrate Lab 4A. I'll be using gel electrophoresis to confirm that the digest in Laboratory 2 was successful. This will show me that I have the gene of interest, the RFP, in my plasmid. Here are the reagents and the equipment that I'll be using in Lab 4A. Notice that they're similar to what we used in Lab 1.2, except this time we'll be using samples that contain DNA and not just dyes. These are the experimental and the control samples from the digest in our last lab, Lab 2A. Because these samples are clear, I'm going to add loading dye to each tube so that I can load them into separate wells in the gel. I'll load DNA ladder into another well. The DNA ladder contains samples of DNA fragments of known sizes that we can compare to our fragments from our experimental and control tubes. Now I'm going to add 2 microliters of loading dye to my R- and R+ tubes. Now I'm ready to centrifuge the tubes. Remember to evenly balance your tubes in the centrifuge, and I'll only need to spin them for a few seconds to make sure everything is mixed and at the bottom of the tubes. Now I'm ready to load the samples into my gel. Notice that my electrophoresis chamber is already set up. I have a gel in place and I've poured buffer just above the level of the gel. I can plug my electrophoresis chamber into the power source. And I'm ready to load my gel. Similar to Lab 1.2, I'm going to add 10 microliters of each of my samples into different wells on the gel. I'm also going to add 10 microliters of DNA ladder to another well on the gel that I can use to measure against my samples. Remember, when you load a gel, you need to keep your arm steady. Insert the tip under the buffer, but just above the well, and only press down on the plunger to the first stop. Now I can press on, make sure that the gel is running at 100 volts, and allow my gel to run. Similar to Lab 1.2, I need to allow the gel to run until the yellow dye is halfway to 3/4 down the gel. I know that my DNA fragments are bigger than the yellow dye fragments, but smaller than the purple dye fragments, so they'll be between those two dyes on the gel. Once the gel is finished running, I'll use a blue light source or a UV light to view the gel. Because we have DNA in the gel, we also have added gel green, a stain that adheres to the DNA and allows us to make the DNA visible, but it's only visible using a UV or a blue light source. Using these results, I can confirm that my plasmid has the gene of interest and then use the plasmid in Laboratory 5A, our bacterial transformation. Again, I'm not going to give away the results of this lab. You'll need to talk to your teacher so that you can see the gel results from your class.